Hello everybody and welcome once again to All The Mods 4. This episode we're going to have a look at Waystones, I think. Let's get started with those, shall we? There aren't actually very many things in Waystones. You've got three different types of Waystones: mossy Waystones, sandy Waystones and Waystones. They're all basically the same. This one's using three obsidian and one of these warp stones. The recipe for warp stones is purple dye in the corner, ender pearls and an emerald. So we've got that already set up. Let's make a couple of these. So that's these warp stones. Craft two of those. They don't stack, as you can see. Let's go to the next item down here, and we've got different types of scrolls. So we've got a warp scroll, which I think is just simply is active warp in this particular case, and this one's bound, not an unbound one, and this is also an unbound return scroll, and this is a bound scroll. Let's look at the recipe for this. So it's basically two gold nuggets and three pieces of paper will produce three of these return scrolls. So let's get I think this is this recipe in here. Yes, it is. There's the two types, as this one is here with these colors in. So let's get those crafted up. So that's the bound scroll, so make three of those, and then we should be able to make three return scrolls as well, like this. Very straightforward. And what you do is you have to right click these onto a waystone. Some of the, what else we've got in here, we've got this one here, which is the I forgot which one. This probably is, yeah, this will be this recipe. This is a warp scroll. Now, the difference between a warp stone and a warp scroll is let's just craft it up. Is that this one takes 5 minutes to reset its time. I think it's 5 minutes. We'll find out in a second. And then let's make a waystone. This is an ordinary one. Have I got any? I need bricks. Or maybe we could make a sandy warpstone with some chiseled sandstone, which is just two sandstone slabs. So sandstone is fairly straightforward. Let's just take a stack of that and make some sandstone. Really just like this. We need at least six of these, I think, would be sensible. Let's just see if six works. Then we need to make these into slabs. In fact, I think, yes, three. No, we only need, therefore, we only need three of these, because then we can make these to give us chisel sandstone. It'll give us three chisel sandstone. So we should be able to make this. If I've got some obsidian, and obsidian will be in this chest here, so let's get that out. That marble, 40 obsidian, 3. Good. An ice bucket challenge. I have actually upgraded the pack to 413, but I've kept the minimap from Zero's minimap and Zero's world map mods, and I removed the journey map, as I told you why last time. So let's just craft up one of these. Like that. So you've seen all the different bits, and the other ones are just the same, so let's not bother with those too much. Now we should have, I should have two waystones. I'll probably put them down somewhere. I think I put one over here. I've, to be honest with you, I can't really remember. It doesn't matter very much for this, for what we're going to do today. So we'll just put this waystone down to start with, sandy waystone. Double check I haven't got it. We'll put it here. And then you right click it and then activates it. So this one's called Remuer. And you used to be able to rename these to your own things. And you can actually shift right click it and you can rename it. So let's call this one Home. So then when you get your warp scroll out here, we have to bind these, don't we? So we've got a, oh, this one's return scrolls are bound to Home. Right, good. And these are bound to nowhere yet. And then when you get your warp stone, so if you're away something like this, and you right click this into the air, hold right click, I think, you get a choice of where you want to go to. Now we've only got one destination at the moment, so we'll just cancel. Press escape and cancel. We'll go and get some, I'll just get some more warp stones. While I'm actually here, there's something I would like to just sort out for us as well. So let's just get rid of this one. I'm not quite sure my achievements have got reset. Let's just hit him with the sword as well. That's got luck on it, all for looting on it. So what do we pick up? Oh, we just picked up one chitin. Right, I'm going to put the sand back, and I'll be back in a second with the bits and pieces I want to do to carry on with this mod. Right, I've just come to the village, which is not protected, so I'm going to just activate this one. I'm going to give it a name, so we'll just call this one Village with Station. Like that. And now I put in it's going to night time, so let's use the warp script. Let's use the warp scroll and just travel back home. So hold this down, and then we've got these two different things, and it tells you how much XP you're going to use to go to these different places. So let's go to home, and here we are. Now, one interesting thing I've noticed, this lamp is definitely brighter than it was. Is that because it's night time? And I've got my written. Let's have a look. Let's just take the helmet off here. You'll see I've got the jetpack on. And if I flick this off and then flick it back on again, it doesn't come out as bright as it was before. Isn't that strange? If it came up, I think that's possibly a bug. Shame about that. Because it would be really good if it came up as bright as that one. We'll see, because that's now turned off. This one should be turned. That should be turned off, and this one should be turned on. Oh, that's strange. That was the wrong way around, wasn't it? Right. So now, you'll see on this waystone, we can't use it for another 300 seconds, about 5 minutes. But of course, we can use the other ones. Since it's night time now, I'll just go and have a quick sleep and come back in a second. Right. So what we can actually do with these warp zones, because the one that's bound to none, I should have bound this one to a village, shouldn't I? So let's have a look. What's this one do? I'm not sure what this one does. Let's right click this one. I think this will allow us to travel to anywhere. That's right. So we can then travel to the walled village and come out here, and they'll put the waystone actually on a mossy block. This is another waystone. We've actually got two from the forest, if you remember rightly. So we can come out here. Now that uses one of the warp scrolls, whereas this one just uses time. In fact, we're pretty near to home. This is new as well. I haven't seen this before. Trash can, so we can chuck stuff away. Now, that showed what I got was a tablet from Plantech 2 Overview, because I upgraded the pack, as I said, to 413, and it gave you a few new items. It might have reset some of the achievements as well. I wonder how many iron golems we've got. We've got two, because one was killed when I was hero of the village. Oh, that reminds me. When I was hero of the village, let's just turn this off and go back home. When I was hero of the village, I went to the other village as well. And when I was in the other village, it's going not drawing as fast as it wants to be, the trees look. When I was here, I went to the other village. I was also here of that village as well, so that was quite interesting. So I could do the trades I really got all the stuff for. Before, let's just turn this off. Oh, it's so fast, it's hard to control. Right, we jump into the water. So basically, that's it for waystones. There's not much more to do, really. You combine, obviously, the other ones you combine to a particular waystone and just travel there straight away. I should have done it, really, shouldn't I? And these warp scrolls. Unfortunately, I didn't, and I'm not sure why. Let's have a look at these lights. Now, since I've been out of here, you see, yeah, that's much brighter. And that's how it should be, really, shouldn't it? This one's now turned off, because the difference is significant. Okay, so the next thing I'd like to look at, I'm jumping around here. Oh, look, there's a... Yes, very interesting. How did he get into there? Because he can't get out. He probably spawned in here, actually. I shall just get rid of him while I'm thinking about it. And while I'm doing that, it takes three shots. Oh, two shots in that case, okay. If I want to get in here, I've got to break my way in. Right. So I'll just break my way and get the XP. And then put the wall back again. Nope, wrong place. Choice of two. I put it on the wrong one. There we go. the next thing we're going to look at was in here. I have got the dank stuff. Now the dank is really neat. Let's just move these out of the way here like this. This is everything I need for the dank, and all this was blue power stuff. So the dank, let's have a look at the dank first of all. I've actually made one up, and that's this one here, dank one. The recipe for this is the wrong place. Let's have a look at this one. Recipe for this one is basically coal around a barrel, so it's pretty cheap as it happens. So let's open it up, because it's got two modes, this, or maybe more. Let's go outside. We've got a crafting table here, that's fine. So you can put it down, which is not the mode we've got at the moment. You can sort its inventory. You'll notice it's got 9 slots, not very much, and dank one. But having said that, these 9 slots store a lot more than just one stack. So let's come out of here and just get a few stacks of, got stone age. Okay, I'm guessing all my achievements here. So I can put all of these stacks into here, I think. So let's just put them in, and you'll see it's storing up more than, right, 256. It can store 256 of any one item. Shift those out again, and then let's start to upgrade this and have a look at each stage of it. So if we look at the uses of this, you'll see we can actually craft that in there. So it's basically 8 blocks of redstone, and we get a dank 2. So look at the dank 2. Now we have two sets of two rows of 9, and we can probably store more than 256. Yes, we can. I'm not exactly sure what we can store in that one. I'd have to go and get the bits and pieces. Let's clip those out of there. Before I go up to the next one, as it says, press shift to info, so you can change its mode with I. So it says it under here, press I to change mode. Current mode use type is bag. Oh yeah, and the stack limit 1024. So now if we then press I on it, it's now a chest, so you can put it down and then you can treat it like a chest. Very clever. If you haven't seen it before, let's pick it up again. It's actually very fast. So let's upgrade this one now. I'll upgrade it through the different bits and have a look at each one of the time as we go through it past. Uses of this one is then blocks of gold. So that's dank 3. Let's press, let's have a look at this one now. So press shift on it this time. So we've got 4096. And again, it's a bag. And if we press I again, it should change the mode to a chest. Does it tell me what mode? It should be telling what mode it is. Press shift for info. So it's now a chest. Press I again. Now it's construction. Aha. I'm absolutely not sure what that means. Let's press I again. And it probably being back to a bag. I'll have to find out what construction means. Let's have a look at this one. Let's open it up this time. So now we've got 3 rows, and it was 4096. So the next one up, uses of this, is blocks of emeralds. Now it starts to get sort of expensive, doesn't it? But it's not too bad now. So let's open up this one. We've now got 4 rows of 9, dank 4, and the tag bit's gone off. I'm not actually sure what the tag does, I think. And we've got the different sort items, but underneath here there's some more. So, hey, can you press it? It looks like there's something underneath this. Never mind. So let's have a look at this again. Let's have a look at this, press shift on it. So this time we've got 16K of information we can store in this bag or chest or construction. Next one up, have a look at uses of this one. So we need, what happens there? Oh, uses of this one. Did I press recipe? So this time we go for diamonds, box of diamonds. So it gives us a dank 5. And then have a look at the uses of this one. Not uses, let's have a look at itself. Press shift again. This time we've got 64K with 6553. 6 is 64 times 1024. How many rows have we got? Probably another row down here. So we've now got five rows of nine. So it's getting a lot. And the NBT data here is probably important. I think if you go too far with the NBT data, you'll actually crash Minecraft and you have to delete stuff. So we'll look at uses of this. So Dank 6, which is with blocks of obsidian. So this one isn't too difficult. It's also got jagged four and chipped. Press control for stats. Well, that's interesting. I'm not quite sure why it gives us that. Well, probably that's something to do with silent gear. So let's have a look at this one. And now we've got it's a diamond chest. And if we have a look at the uses of this one again, press shift for info. So now we've got 256k of stuff. Basically, it's a huge bag. Not a lot of items, any particular items. And you can pick stuff up. So at the moment, it's set to, let's have a look, right click it again. So it's set to pick up. So if I come along here and I drop something on the floor, like some cobblestone, we go to it, it gets picked up. Now, that should automatically be placed into here. Maybe we have to set it up first. So let's put one piece in there and then throw this on the ground. Before I do that, let me just sort this inventory so we can see we've got four stacks. Now this time, oh yes, here we go. So it should tell us one. All right, so the pickup's not working as I expected it to do. All right, I'm getting different stats on this, but I was wondering what I was seeing. So I thought pickup, maybe you have to, you have to right click, you have to click this one and then it picks the stuff up. So now it's in this glowing green mode. Let's just pick it up. And you saw it disappear into there. Let's check all of this on the floor. Pick it up. And then we'll look inside it. So we've got 320 pieces of cobblestone in here. And then you can turn off the pickup mode. No, it's actually in yellow mode. Shift for info. I think you can basically use this for tagging different colours, but I'll have to do some more research why it's got these three different colours. Green, red and yellow and orange. Sorry. Green, yellow and red. So, I'll be back in a second. Right, I'm back. So this thing actually has another layer. I didn't do it. I should have done it, actually. Let's be honest. So we can do the rainbow one, which you basically do by adding eight nether stars. That's not such a problem these days. So I might just do that and come back in a short while when I've done it. I've got the eight nether stars, so you know that's pretty straightforward. But what we can also do is the construction mode. I said I didn't know about it, so I quickly looked at the wiki. It's very straightforward. So you've got if I open it up here, you have different slots. You can put things in your different slots. So I grabbed some dirt, some seeds, and some bone meal. And what you can do with it, so let's just change the mode to being construction, chest construction. And you can see here on the bottom left-hand side, I've got 320 cobblestone highlighted. If I push, hold down the mouse button and scroll around here, then it changes the item in here, as you can see. So we can put down some dirt. Probably need to hoe it as well. Let's just put some dirt down there. Let's just hoe this. So now we can scroll around here and put some seeds in it. So now I've got the achievement seed place. Hold down the shift and scroll again. You can then bone meal this. That's what the construction mode does. Quite neat, isn't it? So there you go. Just like that. So that is how the construction mode works. I'll be back in a few seconds with a few more nether stars. I think I've got four. So let's just have a look, double check what I've got. There'll be mob drops. This is it. Oh, I've actually got six. So I need another two. Right, I'll be back in a short while with another two nether stars. Well, I've been grinding the wither. I've ground another five. I got some interesting things. I actually got my first wither rose. I'm not sure if we've got any uses. We've got lots of uses for this as it happens. A withering trap. Some biomass, which must be a bit too expensive for that. Black dye, that's obviously too expensive for that. and a wither charm. So I need to form more of these and prevent against wither. But actually, it needs quite a few withers you have to grind for this one. What have we got here? A verdant arrow makes the world just a bit more lush. Okay, so you, I think it's probably got other recipes in there. Any flower, yes, I would expect so. I guess you shoot that and it bone meals the ground. So, anyway, let's get on with this thing. Let's now do the upgrade of that. And press uses for upgrade, as it were. And then we've got the rainbow one, Dank 7. Let's have a look at how massive this thing is. Oh, of course, I've got the wrong mode. Let's just get the right mode. That's in construction mode. I think I want bag mode. And you'll see here, when I press right-click, my bow is already for targeting. So this time it's got NBT data, and you can see it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 9 by 9. So it's got 81 slots, which is a pretty big bag. How much is that? Come on, let's get this out of this hand. I'm just going to keep shooting stuff. So let's have a look at the large backpack. This is actually larger, so because that's 9. By 12, that's 108 slots, which is quite a lot, isn't it? Anyway, this Dank will be able to. So look again, look at the use of this one. Press shift on it. I mean, so now we can take 21 million items, which is a lot of stuff. And as she tells me, what I've got in it as well, 20 cobblestone, 1 dirt, and 8 bone meal. That's neat, isn't it? So that basically covers the Dank, as far as I can see. A very useful item. Anyway, until next time, I wish you all the best. Bye for now.